two miles.
And
many of the Jews came to Martha and Mary. To comfort them concerning their brother. Then Martha, as soon as she heard that Jesus was coming, went and met him. But Mary sat still in the house. 21. Then said Martha unto Jesus, Lord, if thou had been here, my brother hadn't died. 22. But I know that even now, whatsoever you will ask of God, God will give it to you. Jesus said unto her, thy brother shall rise
again.
You can be seated. Yes, my brothers and sisters, man shall not live by bread alone, but man shall live with every word that is coming out of the mouth of God. So the life is only in Jesus Christ, because Jesus Christ is life. And Jesus Christ in John 14, from verse 6, he said, I am the life. So the life is Jesus Christ. That's why if you have not Jesus Christ, you are dead. And if you have Jesus Christ, you are alive. And us, we are alive. We believe that we have Jesus Christ in us. That's why we are coming here to hear the word of God. Because we need to prepare ourselves to the second coming of Jesus Christ. Among all the promises, the biggest promises is the second coming of Jesus Christ. Because when Jesus comes for the second time, that's the end of all our sufferings. The end of preachings. We will stop preaching. The Bibles will be closed. We will go with Jesus Christ. And then we will keep singing. That's why we are here. We are preparing ourselves for the second coming of Jesus Christ. Now before Jesus Christ comes, but there are things that we must know. We need to have the instruments to prepare ourselves. That's why we are coming here every time. To hear the word of God. And not only hearing the word of God, we hear the word of God, we preach, and we act upon the word of God we hear. And we say that this is the seventh age, the last time. It pleased God to send the prophets children to the fathers. He was a Baptist preacher. He was preaching the word of God. He was baptizing people according to the scriptures. In the water, in the name of Jesus Christ, and God came. Not to confirm William Branham, but to confirm the commission that he was given. And God told William Branham, as John Baptist was sent to prepare the first coming of Jesus, you are given Jesus Christ. And William Branham, from 1933 up to 1963, 30 years, he was an evangelist. He was a minister, a preacher. Only for 2 years, from 1963 William Branham was now preaching the message of the hour. Now he said, I receive a new ministry. He said, the Bible is open now. But my brothers and sisters, in this world, in this town, yes, there are people with the brochures of William Branham. You heard, you will hear, you will hear. Thus, they believe the message of the hour. Because they are reading the brochures of William Branham. Some of them, they don't preach anymore. They are singing the same songs we are singing. They are organized the way we organize here. Sisters from those churches are like our sisters. But then, they don't understand the message of the hour. Why? Among them, they are saying the rapture came, okay, took place in 1963. That Jesus has come already. Some of them, thunders are revealed. Some of them, William Branham is Jehovah. Some of them, no, the seventh seal is revealed. They created many false doctrines based on the preachings of William Branham, misunderstood. William Branham was a prophet. A prophet can say many things in one thing. Because he loved us, he didn't stop by sending only a prophet. He also sent another ministry according to Matthew 24 verse 47, a faithful servant. This man we are calling Edward Frank, Asia. Ewan Frank is not even a prophet. He's a minister. That's received a grace from God to understand better this message that we believe. Then he came. He said, take all the sermons of William Branham. Don't reject the Bible. Understand that even if I read something in the message of William Branham, I should be able to see it in the Bible. And after we try even to see that, Branham himself said many times that if you hear something from me and you can't find it in the Bible, please take what the Bible says. Because my message is to take you back to the doctrines of the Bible. And we are waiting for the second coming of Jesus Christ. And William Branham is not Jehovah. And William Branham is not a special person. But he received a special ministry. What is the message of the hour? Is the spirit that God sent in this age to understand better the Bible. That's why we are very sure we are on the right way. The time we are today, we can't argue anymore. No, the denominations, they are born again. Oh, they are not born again. No, those are wrong. As we are not again in that time, we praise God because we believe that we are on the right way. The most important thing today is not to try to see what is happening in the nations. What is happening in the life of my brother or my sister? No, the concern for us today, is my heart accepting all the message of the hour? Do I live it? Discussion is over. This is the time for everyone to experience the power of God in his life. We can challenge everybody with the Bible in our hands. Nobody among all the churches we are calling denominations. No one. No church can say we are out of the Bible here. We believe what William Branham preached. He took us back to the Bible. And he preached people. And he received the grace to see those people the other side. He, Christians. He saw them the other side. And he says, sure, people believe the message I bring will enter. Yes, my brothers. This is to assure you that we are not trying to create a new church, not to create a new doctrine. No, we believe what Paul preaches. As we said, William Branham didn't lay a foundation of the doctrine of the church. Now, Jesus Christ is the owner of this church. According to Matthew 16:17, he's got his church. And he's the one who's building his church. Now, the Apostle Paul received the grace to build the foundation of the doctrine in the Church of Jesus Christ. Yes. According to 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 10. And us, all our preachings, our faith, our experiences should be based on the doctrine of apostles. So we are on the right way. Now it's about this Church of Jesus Christ. Now Jesus Christ, he said in Hebrews, without faith, you can't please me. Now what is faith? Faith is not imagination. Faith is not to be courageous. No, faith is a revelation of God in your life according to the word of God. That's why we can preach the word of God the way I'm preaching. Some of the people here are dozing. Some are sleeping. Some are thinking outside. But some also, by the Spirit of God, they are receiving the Word of God. That's why, due to the time, we need to make sure that we are in that church, the Church of Jesus Christ, which will bear to himself in the message of the hour, because you can have all the brochures of William Branham, still we don't have the message of the hour. You can have the brochures of William Branham, but you don't have the message of the hour. If to have the brochures of William Branham is to have the message of the hour, all these standardists, all these other people, they claim to believe the message of the hour. We should be one. We should be in one place. Why are we different? Because they are preaching some of the things which we don't believe. But they have the brochures. If the message of the hour is simply to have this book, the Bible, it's not enough. Because there are people that got the Bibles, the people we are calling denominations, they have Bibles, but they don't have the Word of God. They don't have the message of the hour. The message of the hour, the Word of God, is the word of the loved one sending his love. Yes. Only the person who was addressed the message, who the message was addressed, can receive it and understand. This message, some other They are laughing at us. But us, we believe that in the revelation of the will of God today, and by the grace of God, we know that God sends other ministers. Ephesians chapter 4, 11. They are preaching the same message, taking children back to the fathers. So, my brothers, there will not be a new doctrine. There is only one doctrine. Our doctrine is the Bible. We don't even need to write the doctrine here. No, we believe the Bible. We believe Ephesians chapter 2 verse 20. You are edified on the doctrines of the apostles and prophets. And Jesus Christ himself, the cornerstone. That's our doctrine. We don't need to write the doctrine. Somebody could ask, Pastor, what is our doctrine? This is our doctrine. Now, if we are taken back to that church, the church of apostles, it should not be now the time of God saying, no, I believe the message of the hour. No, our faith is taken back to the faith of apostles. We are the church of Jesus Christ. And we have the truth. Okay, if we have the truth, the truth is a person. The truth is Jesus Christ. And Jesus says, I am the life. If you have the life, you are alive. If somebody is alive, people will see that he's alive. And if you are dead, people can see this one is dead. A living person, see me, you will see that he's alive. Singing for God, you will see that this person is alive. You believe the truth. No, we have the truth. Jesus Christ says, I am the truth. My brothers, it's not things to guess or imagination. Jesus Christ is the life. If you say you believe Jesus Christ, you should have the life which was in Jesus Christ. And people, starting by yourself, you must know that you have the life. Every woman knows that she's pregnant. Find out before even the husband to know, the woman knows that she's pregnant. She knows how she's feeling. Things will change. Even the test will change. She can't decide to change. No, the life in her. The word of God in you, and you are the same. No, it means maybe that you received was not the life. That's why we need to hear the pure
word of Christ.
We can't stop repeating that. As here, we don't need opinions. Something, but according to me, in my opinion, if you don't have the word of God, just sit. Another person with the word of God will come and teach us. We don't need your explanations. How was the church of apostles? We have just read the history which happens in John 11. 18. The same one as we said yesterday. Then Jesus came and called. Look, because we are different. As we are different, when these Pentecostals talking about Jesus, okay, we respect that. But some of them, Jesus is the second person in the Godhead. But for us, Jesus Christ, that Jehovah. We say Jesus Christ is not a man made God. No, Jesus Christ is God made man. When Adam broke the word of God. All of us, we come from Adam. Adam broke the word of God. And all of us, we were cursed. All the humanity, everybody, just by birth, you are cursed. There's no way for a man to please God. No way. And God himself should come and redeem a man. This earth was cursed. And you remember in Genesis chapter 2 or 3, God says the earth shall produce thrones. Eh? What?
The thrones.
The earth was cursed. You, even if a man was not cursed, you are living on the land which is cursed. Even if I don't tell you that you are also cursed, but you are living on the land which is cursed. Everybody, even the babies that we have, that's why us we don't believe little angels. And sometimes I see some schools called little angels. No. Angels are not babies. We can't have little angels. No, angels are angels. They don't multiply themselves. They are angels. The earth was cursed. And the man was living on the land which is cursed. And God told the man, God, the land is cursed, and it will produce thorns. Now, everybody on earth, there's no one who will go in hell because they sinned. Nobody. My brothers, my sisters, you will not go to hell because you commit adultery. You will not go to hell because you killed people. No, you will go to hell because you reject what God did on Calvary. We didn't ask God to be born. We didn't ask God to be created. God created us. All of us. We came from Adam. Adam broke the word of God. So he pulls all of us in death. Innocent. We are innocent, but condemned by representation. Of what God told Eve. They are innocent, but represented by Eve.